Successful capture of the Super Heavy during Flight 7 was a watershed moment in rocketry. However, is it truly without flaws? For example, have you noticed any potential concerns regarding the Starship Gritvins? In particular, the B-1 Gritvins present certain troubling aspects that are worthy of scrutiny. Mary Cota discusses them on today's episode of NR Studio. While much attention has been paid to the explosions after Starship's flight, it's important not to underestimate the small issues that have the potential to greatly impact the overall performance of the vehicle. A particular concern concerns the B-1 Gritvins, which are a critical element in the Super Heavy rocket's design. These Gritvins operate analogously to the flaps on an airplane's wings, helping to control the vehicle's flight trajectory. However, for the Super Heavy, the Gritvins serve a more critical function during landing, facilitating a careful and safe landing operation. This is especially important, considering that the booster re-enters Earth's atmosphere at speeds that exceed twice the speed of a bullet fired from an assault rifle. However, it was observed during the seventh flight, after a successful warm-up stage, that the B-1 Gritvins showed minor deformations compared to their original configuration. These deformations arose from the considerable heat generated during the warm-up stage process, when the Starship upper stage fired its Raptor engines to separate from the boosters. The temperatures were so severe that even Elon Musk has acknowledged the difficulties posed by the situation. To mitigate some of the heat, the ventilated inner stage was equipped with a protective dome designed to protect the Super Heavy's upper stage from the exhaust gases generated by the second stage's engines. Despite this mitigation strategy, the steel Gritvins remained vulnerable to the severe temperatures and pressures they faced. Although the observed deformations did not significantly impact the flight, the B-1 still made a remarkable landing. The damage, while minimal, underscores the challenges SpaceX faces in its quest to achieve full Starship reusability. To achieve its lofty goal of accelerated reusability, Starship must not only secure a successful landing, but also ensure that every component is capable of making subsequent flights without extensive repairs. This presents a formidable challenge. Musk is optimistic that SpaceX could achieve its objectives as soon as next year. However, every stride towards this ambition necessitates meticulous scrutiny of even the minutest damages. In pursuit of enhancing the Gritvin on Starship, SpaceX stands to gain significantly by capitalizing on the advancements achieved through their Falcon 9 rocket. Historically, Falcon 9's grid fins were crafted from aluminum. However, SpaceX has since shifted to titanium as the preferred material for these essential components. The transition to titanium Gritvins, meticulously forged from a singular component via sophisticated casting and machining techniques, has conferred numerous benefits concerning durability and performance. Titanium Gritvins offer exceptional maneuverability and improved resilience to the extreme heat encountered during re-entry, outperforming their aluminum equivalents. These enhancements have significantly increased the Gritvins' resilience to the elevated temperatures experienced during the booster's return, thereby ensuring that the fins can endure extreme conditions more effectively than previously. Beyond their superior durability, the titanium Gritvins on the Falcon 9 also markedly enhance reusability. These fins necessitate minimal maintenance between flights, a vital consideration in SpaceX's pursuit of maximizing the reusability of their rockets. This constitutes a vital element of their overarching strategy aimed at minimizing launch expenses and enhancing the efficiency of space missions. The Gritvins on the Falcon 9 are designed for deployability, allowing them to be extended post-launch and retracted when they are not in use. This feature is paramount as it enables the rocket to reduce drag effectively, thereby enhancing its aerodynamic control throughout the phases of ascent and descent. One potential advantage of this technology for Starship lies in the integration of deployable Gritvins on the Super Heavy booster, a critical component of the Starship system. At present, Starship has deliberately chosen to forgo the incorporation of a deployable mechanism for its Gritvins, primarily to achieve weight reduction. Nevertheless, this decision entails certain trade-offs, especially in terms of addressing the elevated temperatures produced during the hot staging process. By implementing the Gritvins solely subsequent to the completion of the hot staging process, SpaceX can effectively prevent exposing the fins to extreme conditions, thereby potentially extending their lifespan and preserving the structural integrity of the Gritvins throughout numerous flights. Although Starship's existing design prioritizes a heightened, more direct configuration, The integration of deployable grit fins could markedly enhance reusability and overall performance. Nevertheless, Booster 1 faced a multitude of challenges during its seventh flight, extending beyond merely the complications associated with the grit fins. In the course of the boost back burn, a total of 12 out of the 13 Raptor engines achieved successful ignition. While this raised certain apprehensions, SpaceX successfully reactivated the absent engine just prior to the landing burn, facilitating B-1's safe descent and landing. Speculation has arisen suggesting that the engine which failed to ignite may be Engine 31, previously repurposed from the fifth flight of Starship. Nevertheless, this conjecture has been disproven, as Engine 31 resides on the periphery of the engine cluster and is specifically engineered to activate solely during takeoff, rather than during the boostback phase. Irrespective of the engine in question, this incident underscored a pivotal domain requiring enhancement. SpaceX must undertake comprehensive testing and implement requisite modifications to guarantee that forthcoming flights are not beset by comparable challenges. This aspect will hold particular significance as the company advances its initiatives for Flight 8, since these seemingly minor issues could accumulate over time and potentially impact the overall efficacy of the Starship system. In reference to Flight 8, preparations are currently in progress at Starbase. In true SpaceX style, the company initiates preparations for the subsequent flight even before the current one has concluded. On December 29th of the previous year, B-15 was subjected to cryogenic testing, while the ship for Flight 8, designated S-3, has successfully completed its cryotesting at Massey and has subsequently returned to Mega Bay 2 for the subsequent phase of preparations. Although these developments indicate a favorable trajectory, the path forward is not devoid of obstacles. SpaceX is concurrently advancing the construction of its second launch tower, having successfully transported the chopsticks for Pad B from Sanchez, which are now poised for installation. Nevertheless, notwithstanding Musk's certainty regarding the readiness of Flight 8 next month, this schedule appears to be quite ambitious, particularly in light of the requisite FAA approval, extensive testing, and the unavoidable challenges associated with such a sophisticated program. Realizing this schedule demands more than mere serendipity, even considering SpaceX's impressive history, it is probable that this timeline will face an extension. Notwithstanding the hurdles and obstacles encountered with Starship, SpaceX persists in achieving significant advancements with its other spacecraft. Recently, the Falcon 9 rocket achieved a remarkable milestone. It has triumphantly accomplished its 0-0 landing. The Falcon 9 mission, integral to the Starlink 11-8 series, ascended from Vandenberg Space Force Base on a Tuesday afternoon. The mission successfully launched 27 second-generation Starlink satellites, setting a new benchmark for this category of satellites. Originally set to commence on Sunday, the mission faced a postponement as an aircraft intruded into the designated keep-out zone merely 11 seconds prior to liftoff. The delay did not impede the success of the mission. On the subsequent attempt, Falcon 9 executed a flawless launch at 7:05 a.m. local time. The triumphant landing of Booster B-1082 signifies the 117th successful touchdown on SpaceX's drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You, and represents the 0-0 the overall booster recovery achieved by the company. This represents a noteworthy achievement, highlighting SpaceX's proficiency in the consistent recovery and reutilization of boosters, a crucial element in the reduction of space access costs. The B-1082 has previously been employed in missions such as USSF-62, OneWeb, and multiple Starlink launches. It stands as one of four boosters that have been exclusively launched from the West Coast, further reinforcing SpaceX's supremacy in the realm of reusable rocket technology. A key factor contributing to the success of the Starlink missions is the continuous advancement of SpaceX's satellite technology. The Starlink 5-2 mini optimized satellites exhibit enhanced capabilities and reduced weight compared to their predecessors. SpaceX has disclosed that the latest satellites are 22% lighter than their forerunners, thereby enabling a greater number of satellites to be deployed in each mission. The V-2 mini satellites feature an advanced backhaul antenna powered by SpaceX's custom Doppio chip, which improves overall performance. The satellites are equipped with enhanced avionics, propulsion, and power systems, allowing the Falcon 9 to accommodate as many as 29 satellites per launch, an increase of 6 compared to the initial V2 mini configuration. These improvements optimize efficiency and allow SpaceX to meet the growing demand for internet connectivity around the world. In conjunction with the Starlink initiative, the Falcon 9 recently performed a landmark launch, successfully delivering two lunar landers into orbit. The mission featured the Japanese lander Resilient, along with the privately held U.S. company Blue Ghost, both integral components of the initiative to establish a sustainable human presence on the Moon. These missions represent a significant leap forward in humanity's goal of space exploration and highlight the Falcon 9's critical role as a reliable and economically viable launch vehicle for deep space endeavors. Despite its aerospace dominance, SpaceX currently faces a growing number of competitive forces. Blue Origin, a rival in the aerospace sector, has made significant progress with its New Glenn rocket. On January 16, 2025, New Glenn successfully completed its maiden mission, propelled by 7 BE engines, and successfully achieved orbital insertion during its maiden voyage. The launch was a major milestone for Blue Origin, as it successfully delivered the GS-2 upper stage and Blue Ring prototype payload to medium Earth orbit for the first time. However, despite the loss of the GS-1 first stage during descent, the mission was deemed a success because the payload successfully reached its designated orbit. Despite the setback of the lost booster, Blue Origin is diligently examining its re-entry and has formulated plans for a second flight in the spring, pending the outcome of FAA review. Blue Origin's rise, coupled with continued advancements in space technology, is further increasing competitive pressure on SpaceX. The race to create a more sophisticated and reliable space transportation system is intensifying, with fans of both companies eagerly anticipating significant advances to come. Whether it's SpaceX's Starship or Blue Origin's New Glenn, the horizon of space exploration is filled with limitless opportunities. These pioneering companies aren't just competing. They're catalyzing each other's progress, pushing the boundaries of innovation and achievement to unprecedented levels. The stakes have reached unprecedented heights, and the coming years are poised to reveal transformative moments that will resonate and inspire generations to come. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.